in every way, if you've been wearing a mask, it's time to take the mask off. Because as it stands right now, the government has every right to seize your church and to throw your pastor into jail. And it has every right to dictate when you can meet and where you can meet and how many of you can meet and what your pastor can preach when you do meet. With the time of great tribulation ahead of us, those of us who are truly Christians are probably going to end up in prison or dead. But those of you who think that you're Christians, and even worse, those of you who pretend to be Christians, you're giving up everything for nothing when you claim to be fighting for biblical truth and religious freedoms as if you were true Christians like we are. That's just causing confusion. And God's not the author of confusion. So you're getting yourself in trouble with the government and with the Lord for nothing. He's not leading you in make-believe Christianity. So stop pretending to be a Christian and start finding out from the Bible what it means to actually be one. In every way, if you've been wearing a mask, it's time to take the mask off. Because as it stands right now, the government has every right to seize your church and to throw your pastor into jail. And it has every right to dictate when you can meet and where you can meet and how many of you can meet and what your pastor can preach when you do meet. Does the truth mean anything to you? The government has every right to arrest you for non-compliance if you don't follow social distancing orders and masking orders when you meet at church. Because the place that you call church is not the church that Jesus said he would build when he said in Matthew 16:18, "Upon this rock I will build my church." Your church is a government church, and the government has every right to tell you what to do and what to say when you meet there, because you agreed to those terms when you chose to join that church or even to attend that church. You rendered unto Caesar the things that are God's instead of rendering unto Caesar only the things that are Caesar's. You appealed to Caesar to make a denomination and a church within that denomination in the first place. You appealed to Caesar to build a church building and to attend that church building. And so Caesar is now rightfully in control of your spiritual well-being. In fact, Caesar even pays some of you a nice tax deduction for attending and maintaining and contributing to his church. You literally have a legal contract with him, the government. And that is spiritually the very same as having a legal contract with the devil himself. You agreed that the government could create your church. Your denomination, whether Baptist or Pentecostal or whatever, is a corporation, an artificial entity created by the government that the government has every right to direct and to control. On the other hand, the true church is one that Jesus said he would build. Matthew 16:18 says, "Upon this rock I will build my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail against it," he said. And his church isn't divided into denominations because his body isn't divided. You proudly call yourself a Baptist or a Pentecostal or whatever. Just like the Apostle Paul rebuked the carnal Corinthians for doing. Every one of you saith, "I am of Paul," and "I am of Apollos," an eye of Cephas, an eye of Christ. Is Christ divided? He asked. No, of course not. But by your words and by your actions, you say that he is. And you say that you go to church. But it's impossible for a true Christian to go to church, because those of us who are true Christians, we are the church. We don't go to church because we are the church. And we don't pretend that we are defending the gospel and serving the Lord by kicking the government out of its own government churches, Caesar's churches. If your church is incorporated, that means that the government created it. And the government has every right to be there and to control it. Those of us who are true Christians don't call ourselves Baptists or Pentecostals or any other government-sanctioned man-made names. We call ourselves Christians and disciples, as God's Word, the Bible, tells us to call ourselves. It says the disciples were called Christians first in Antioch. And it says, do not rich men oppress you and blaspheme that worthy name by the which ye are called? As I quoted Jesus in my last video, render therefore unto Caesar the things which are Caesar's, and unto God the things which are God's. We don't drink the cup of the Lord and the cup of devils, because the Bible says you cannot be partakers of the Lord's table and of the table of devils. But that is what people are trying to do by going to church and calling themselves Baptist Christians, Pentecostal Christians, and claiming to be Bible-believing Christians. Well, if you're doing that, then stop it. All you're doing is causing confusion, and you're not helping anyone. You're not helping yourself. You're not sharing the true gospel with lost people in the world. And you're not serving the Lord. In fact, you are the people who will say to him on that day, Lord, Lord, have we not prophesied in thy name? And in thy name have cast out devils? And in thy name have done many wonderful works? And he'll profess to you, I never knew you. Depart from me, ye that work iniquity. So if you go to church, then stop it and start being the church instead. And if you call yourself a Baptist or Pentecostal, then stop it and start being a Christian instead. The only way you can do that is to stop supporting and stop being a part of any and every government church, any government denomination that you are presently supporting and attending. Stop attending Satan's churches, Satan's denominations, and instead let the Lord graft you into his body, his true church. He is as good as his word, because he is his word. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. And the Word was made flesh and dwelt among us. The King James Bible is the true and only Word of God in English. You can trust it exactly as it is worded, and it perfectly explains the truth of these things. Have you noticed how spineless your pastors are? That's because they aren't biblical Christians. For such are false apostles, deceitful workers, transforming themselves into the apostles of Christ. And no marvel, for Satan himself is transformed into an angel of light. Therefore, it is no great thing if his ministers also be transformed as the ministers of righteousness, whose end shall be according to their works. They love the applause of men. They love their government-subsidized incomes. So they deceive you, and they make merchandise of you, and they betray the Lord. Have you noticed how misguided your pastors are, even if they aren't among the spineless ones? There appear to be maybe three denominational pastors in all of Canada who actually have some backbone and who are willing to go to prison for what they believe. Shame on the rest of you. And shame on all the rest of your pastors. But regrettably, even these three men are misguided, resting with the scriptures to their own destruction, believing that denominational Christianity is true Christianity when it's not. Denominational Christianity, or corporate Christianity, which includes every so-called Christian denomination, is false Christianity. Every so-called Christian church is a corporation, a government entity, a government church, and it's not the true church. No church created by the government is the church that Jesus said he would build. So all of denominational Christianity is false Christianity. Yes, that's true. All of denominational Christianity is false Christianity. And God says, "Come out of her, my people, that ye be not partakers of her sins, and that ye receive not of her plagues." God says, "Come out of her, my people." Your pastors have failed you by not telling you these things. Your pastors have failed you by preaching from false Bible versions. And your pastors have failed you by preaching false doctrines, even from the true Bible, when they use it in ignorance or deceit to keep you trapped in that false Christianity, so they can keep their jobs, their income, their money, while they pretend to be ministers of righteousness in the government churches and lead you, their flock, to the slaughter and to destruction. There's a famine in the land, not a famine of bread, but of hearing the words of the Lord. And you had better start loving the truth and learning the truth while you're still free enough to believe the truth, or you'll never hear the words of the Lord again in time. Because the day is almost upon us when all the choices that you have left to choose from are only various versions of a lie, because you didn't receive the love of the truth when you had the chance to look for it and to receive it as it is in truth, the Word of God, which liveth and abideth forever. My name is Mike Wright, and if the Lord is willing, I'll have another video for you shortly.